old friend William.
By tonight, but he's not my friend anymore.
Who is he?
William? Just an old sailor who loves his gin too much. He worked for years at the Closed.
Is he dangerous?
Yeah. Like many drunks, he's all bark and no bite. Can barely stand up most of the time.
How was he tonight? Was he different?
Sicker than usual, perhaps. He whined and mumbled about how mean people were to him and how he'd like to talk to me outside.
I need to find him. It's a matter of urgency. Do you know where he is?
You could try his boat. It's up by the North Pier. He sleeps there when he's too drunk to get home.
Please describe him to me.
What do you expect? He's a tall, sick bastard with a bad rash and torn old clothes. William used to be strong. Now he's a mess.
Thank you, Tom.
If you see him, tell him I don't want him back here unless he cleans up his act, okay?
Are they stupid or
it's locked.
Stupid or something. I've never even been to India.
I will get to the bottom of this intrigue. What's been done to me, to this city? The body is still warm. This man has just been drained of blood. This man was armed. He tried to defend himself. This corpse has been dried of its blood, just like the previous victim. What's this? Some sort of note. Blood and empty gin bottles. This Bishop fellow is something of a heavy drinker. There are blood splats on the other side of the canal. I must reach that barge.
safer places to be than here. Over there!
Surprised we can't change his clothes yet.
Watch yourselves! There's one of them! Oh, Christ! Let's see how it looks!
Over there!
Fresh blood. The whole building reeks of it. The scent is so strong it makes me dizzy.
Fail.
places to be than here.
Stupid beast!
Over there! done it before.
This creature is bedeviled. I must put it down.
William was an honorable man. I could have saved him.
Mr. Hampton, are you in there?
We knew him well. Another lost soul, a kindred spirit.
Sir, listen to the sound of my voice. I'm a doctor. You're suffering from shock.
I must return to my flock. They'll stray without me.
Remember, certain Skulls are every bit as resistant as we are.
Who are you? What do you mean by Skull?
You truly are a newborn. I should have realized.
Wait. You are the woman from the bar. Are you like me? Can you help me?
I believe, sir, I already have.
George and the Saints, you've solved the mystery of these terrible murders. Patience, good fellows, I've come to offer help. Just give me a moment to secure my boat. We can leave this awful place.
Oh, Lord.
William was not the evil man they claimed. He was just taken by the thirst. He needed his drink.
This man requires medical attention. We'll see he gets to the nearest hospital.
No, please, I almost tempt my fold. My flock needs me.
Yes, sir. Go with the good Dr. Swansea. He's resourceful, and I'm sure he'll take good care of you.
You'd best come as well. The sun is soon to rise, and you'll need a place to rest.
I just need a moment. If I can learn something about what has happened to William, I'll be a step closer to understanding what happened to me. This poor creature can't be my maker. Could it be some subspecies of vampire? I must find a place to analyze the blood.
At dawn we row! Yes, and welcome to Lady Dark Gaming, everybody.
To the Pembroke Hospital. It's just across the canal. They'll have a bed for poor Mr. Hampton.
William was... What manner of creature was he?
Predator, prey, villain, and victim. Who can say? The important thing is that he's been stopped.
Duly noted. And the woman? What? Who is she?
What woman?
Oh, don't play me for a fool. You used me to locate that Skull. You must know who she is.
I thought you a gentleman. You shouldn't talk about a lady behind her back, but I will tell you she values her privacy. Were London as peaceful as she appears from the middle of the canal? If only that were the reality of the situation.
To be honest, I've always tried to avoid this part of town.
Pembroke Hospital is the last bastion between the rest of London and the epidemic. The flu has decimated the East End and the war still rages. Welcome to the front lines of a plague.
This is where you work, Dr. Swansea.
I am the administrator of Pembroke Hospital.
I thought you were here in service of your mysterious order, the Brotherhood of...
Of St. Paul's Stone, yes. But first and foremost, I'm a man of science. A physician, like yourself, Dr. Reed.
How do you know who I am?
No need for modesty. You are Dr. Jonathan Reed, a surgeon of some caliber and renown, if I'm not mistaken.
You are correct, sir.
I knew it! I had my suspicions. But when you took the blood sample from the corpse of poor William, I was certain. Dr. Reed. Marvelous.
Have we met?
I attended three of your seminars before the war. I have the utmost admiration for your research. And what a turn of fate. England's most esteemed blood specialist returns to London a vampire.
That word, again, from a so-called man of science.
I understand. Traditionally, the role of science is to refute myth, but when myth walks among us, the Brotherhood of St. Paul has dedicated its purpose to their study. There's so much for you to learn.
Of that, you are right.
Well, then let me be blunt. Join my staff at Pembroke Hospital. As a physician. I suspect you'll not find a better post of employment to contemplate your predicament.
This is sudden. I was returning home to see my sickly mother. But alas, that was before contracting this affliction.
Dr. Reed, take a moment to consider. The post would be for the night shift, providing a good explanation for your absence during daylight hours. You'll be adequately reimbursed and have a place to hide. I even had the forethought to bring some clean clothes. So, what do you say?
It seems I have little choice, but yours is a generous offer, so I thank you.
Brilliant! Oh, Jonathan, this is one for the book. The beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Yay! Maya.
Dr. Swansea, thank goodness. I was beginning to be concerned.
Worry no more, Nurse Crane, for I bring good news.
Oh, Doctor, what a night. We lost two more patients. Nurse Scow said she couldn't take it anymore and resigned.
Yes, well, I'll make a new rotor in the morning. In the meantime, find a good bed for Mr. Hampton. Be sure to pay attention to his needs.
Of course, Doctor.
Oh, and Dorothy?
Yes, Doctor?
Dr. Reed here has just returned from the front. He served King and Country and will be joining us here at Pembroke. We're very lucky to have gained a surgeon of his talent, and one so experienced in blood transfusions.
That is good news indeed, Doctor.
Oh, yes. Here at Pembroke, it's not what we have, but what we haven't. It's only thanks to Nurse Crane and the staff that our ship is in sync. If you have any questions, just ask her.
Duly noted. Thank you.
Your assistance is required, Dr. Swansea, immediately.
Welcome aboard, Jonathan. We'll catch up after my rounds. Coming, Nurse Crane. I'm coming.
Life. Drink at this river. Come on, you bastard! I won't bite!
Sir, please! You've lost too much blood. Calm yourself.
You think I didn't notice? Stop your staring and get me to an hospital, you ass!
Insulting a good Samaritan. Not exactly the way to get rescued.
All right, sorry. I am in pain here. My guts are spilling out onto the street and you're yabbering on.
Yes. That's a very nasty wound you've got there. Take my word, I am a doctor. Dr. Jonathan Reed.
Name's Clay Cox. I'd appreciate you helping me to a better place, Doc.
Follow me, Mr. Cox. Let me assist you to that better place.
I am so confused. Okay.
With new staff members, no matter how illustrious they may be.
I apologize, nurse. I needed some time to myself. This has been the longest and strangest night of my life.
You delivered poor Mr. Hampton from a terrible fate. The means to that end should be of little concern, Doctor.
Thank you, nurse. What can I do for you?
Dr. Swansea insisted we provide you a quiet office. You'll find it on the second floor, with your name on the door.
Thank you. Nurse Crane, isn't it?
Yes, Dorothy Crane. Welcome to Pembroke Hospital, Dr. Reed. Your office has been prepared.
I would like to ask a few questions first. If you could point me in the direction of my room again, nurse.
Second floor of the hospital, left after the stairs. It's the last vacant office at the end of the corridor.
And Mr. Hampton, the patient we brought in. How does he fare?
I gave him a sedative to help him sleep. Poor thing was in quite a state of shock.
What kind of man is Dr. Swansea?
Well, you accepted the job from him. I thought you would have known about your employer.
It's right to assume Dr. Swansea knows far more about me than I do about him.
You'll get to know him soon enough, and better than me. The administrator has better things to do than mix with us.
Thank you, Nurse Crane. Dr. Swansea is right. This place seems perfect to conduct my research. This must be the place. It's definitely away from prying eyes. Relegated to the shadows. A kingdom of my own. At least I won't be sleeping in a coffin. Flower's dying. It needs water. William Bishop's blood is much more unstable than human blood and shows extensive mutation. But this is not what happened to me. I must keep on searching. The sun is about to rise. I can feel it. I'll continue tomorrow night. I have so much time.
Interesting. Oh, Lord. You know what, Melissa? Hide. I don't give a fuck, so.
Better learn to hide my true nature from the mortals. What about my thirst for blood?
Thirst for blood.
Yes, Nurse Crane? How can I help you?
I'm so sorry. I know Dr. Swansea wanted you to rest, but we have somewhat of a crisis.
A crisis, you say?
A crisis?
Our antiseptics is nearly depleted. I was hoping there was another box up here, but...
What type of hospital are you running? No antiseptics?
You have been away too long, Doctor. With the war, and now this epidemic, supplies have been running scarce for months now.
I may have a solution. In France, during the war, drugs shortage was a daily problem. We had to use our wits to overcome the shortages.
However do you mean?
If combined correctly, certain household chemical products can be used in a pinch instead. Now, where's the hospital storeroom?
The storeroom? Fat chance. This is the Pembroke. And space is luxury we don't have. Everything used to be stored in the old morgue.
Perhaps I should look there first. Where is this morgue?
It's the large building behind the hospital. You'll need to go in the back door because it's been sealed off for sanitary reasons. Take this key. It opens a small back entrance at the end of a narrow street.
The abandoned morgue behind the hospital. A small door at the end of a narrow street. On my way then. Thank you, nurse. Good evening, nurse.
Good evening, Doctor. I don't think we've been introduced yet. My name is Pippa Hawkins.
And I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. Dr. Swansea has recently offered me a position in this hospital.
Well, it's a euphemism that your help will be appreciated, Doctor.
Goodbye, Nurse Hawkins. Enter. Scowl voices in the garden. I should investigate. If they were to find somebody.
Look! Good evening. I'm Dr.
Always a pleasure to meet a colleague, sir. Especially when he was supposedly dead.
A colleague? Are you a doctor too?
Not anymore, sir. I used to be Dr. Rakesh Jadhana. Now, I'm just Mr. Jadhana. Pawnbroker and humble guardian of this morgue.
What do you mean? You used to be a doctor. Was your license revoked?
No, sir. It is just that I like to be precise. I run a little pawn shop while taking care of the dead. But I used to be a real doctor.
Goodbye, Mr. Jadhana.
I'm sorry you ended up on my plane and cold medical bench, sir.
I understand the situation.
I managed to arrange to have you buried in the same mass grave as your wife. I hope.
It's locked, all right.